In round three of the Gibraltar Masters, there was a lot of confusion and drama as the playing hall was without electricity for over an hour. But the one game for which it did not matter at all was Ivan Chaparinov versus Yuffa Daniel. Ivan, in a complicated Grunfeld, came out on top in just 23 moves. He explains us how he did it. Ivan, a dramatic day here at the Gibraltar Masters with the power cut and but your game was equally dramatic.
Yeah, it's...
Take us through that first.
Well, first, I'm glad I'm here. This means that I won again. So, it was a bit of a disaster for the organizers because 1 hour is too long, but okay, it's not their fault. So I just hope that there are no bad feelings of the players. No, but it can happen, no, everywhere. So. And my game, yeah, it was very interesting. So I'll show it's Grunfeld again. Okay, the last time I was commentating here, it was Grunfeld again, so it's this line with h4, which is very popular nowadays. To be honest, I was a bit not professional today, because I saw that he played one game with this line, but I didn't expect him to play somehow so aggressive. And I had some very old analysis that I briefly checked before the game, but I'll show now, this was not so clear, because okay, this is the most sharpest line.
And this was yourself, of course, in your preparation?
Yeah, I'm still in my preparation, but so this is the critical position. Now there are many moves, d6 is very interesting. Also, e5, this is the most theoretical stuff, that there are many games with d6, e6, no, sorry, e6.
Yeah, let me just...
Yes, rook h7.
Oh,
rook
wow.
Rook e5, and there are many, many games here. Okay, I don't know so many, but there are a lot of games.
So the point is that you can't take here because knight g5, and then you've got
g4, so
queen
g5. G4. Yeah, there are many games, so okay, here I was prepared. But rook h4 is an interesting move, and before the game, I checked a little bit of their new games, because my analysis were like a few years ago, so I was not sure. And okay, I just checked very quickly my analysis. I said, okay, he will not play like this, so I stopped. But the point is that, okay, d6, here I think the main line is knight b5, for me it was at least the main line. Here, knight c3, h5,
you can just go.
h5, bishop d2, so this is the was the main position for me, but it's sort of black was okay after bishop d4, rook g4, bishop g4, something.
This position looks completely a mess already.
Absolute mess, yeah, but okay, in the end it was draw. So after knight g4, but I cannot say all the line because I don't remember, to be honest. So after knight g4, okay, he played d6, which is also critical. There are one game, I think, there was some game, I don't remember.
You just mentioned a couple of moves ago as well that white had this option of d6.
Yes.
So d6 is a very thematic idea for white.
D6, it was played by Mamedyarov against Navarra here.
So just explain to our viewers, because it just looks like you're giving the pawn away.
At some point you want to take on c4 with check. For example, if I take now here, this was the main line, take knight b5, now the both pawns are hanging.
Knight c7 is threatened, knight d6
so
and bishop
c. Now the main move was d5. So if knight c7, it was kind of unclear because of I was just taking here and playing, I think, rook f7, some cow move, and then bishop b7, and black is probably better. And after d5, I think this was the main line. And, it was very, very complicated. But, okay, this I could remember because this I checked before the game, so...
Okay.
So it was this line. No, I just show because it's very interesting. Knight e5, knight e4. And some stuff like knight c6, c3, and rook a2, and
wow.
It continues. And in the end, I think the line was just short because it's very funny. Take bishop d3, bishop g4, take here.
Has this been played before?
This is
all part of your analysis.
It's very nice, rook d2.
Oh, wow.
In the end, it's a draw, but this is very interesting.
So in the end, it's 0-0.
Yeah. But okay, he played rook h4, very interesting move, knight g4, d6.
Did he take a while before he played rook h4?
No, he played immediately because he knew knight g4 and he played immediately d6. He told me just after the game that after bishop b6 he was out of book. But actually it's funny because this position, there are some other moves, but for some reason my auto-analysis said bishop b6 and I kind of stopped. The only thing I remembered was that knight g5 is bad because bishop d4, take, check. And here I give mate. If you take on d8 or give 2, it's mate.
Oh, that's an incredible line.
Yeah, so this is the only thing I
remember.
So
if king e1, you just go rook g2.
Yes. Or maybe rook c2 or rook b2, or I don't know. But okay, after knight g5, after bishop b6, it was very strange because I played instantly And I want to show that I know everything, but actually it was not the truth, because I realized that after rook g4 he can take a8, and I didn't remember this, and it looked very strange, but okay, I remember the main line was a4 for some reason, and black was playing some random move like here, and okay, and I stopped because I said, okay.
It's never going to happen.
Yes, but here when I played b6, I realized that rook g4 is just winning a piece, and I said, okay, it would be completely stupid if I just lose like this, you know, because he just take and... But then, okay, then I had a few minutes to calm myself and to see that after queen d7, probably I'm still okay. But it was a bit of a shock because I didn't expect, I didn't have for some reason in my analysis, I didn't have rook g4.
You didn't have rook g4, but you...
Or maybe I didn't saw, I don't know, because it was very quick and maybe I didn't saw, or maybe I didn't have, I don't know.
But Ivan, you had bishop e6 and this you remembered.
Yes.
This is an interesting point, because if you remember that you had bishop e6, you probably know that there is queen d5, some, queen
yes,
is not working.
No, but this was not the main move, rook g4, so probably it's bad. So I just, the point is that I played very fast and I said, okay, sometimes you know, you played, you think that you remember something, but maybe you played, you misplayed, you know, maybe you had some other position on the board, I don't know. So I felt very, really stupid when he took. But then, okay, I had like a few minutes and I understood that after queen d7, black is better. Yeah.
And the point is that this queen here is
knight c6
stuck.
Is coming, and okay, now the critical line is what he played. He played knight here.
Was he still blitzing out moves? Or
no, after bishop b6, he talked for maybe 15 minutes and he took on g4, and yeah, so this happened. And here, okay, knight h2 is the only move to try to take the bishop, because knight d5 I think is just bad, because the point is if knight c6, queen c6.
Yeah, so you can't go knight c6 instantly,
yes.
We'll just have that on the board.
Knight c7, yes. So after knight d5, I want to take...
Queen d5.
Take bishop b6. And after queen c5, okay, knight a6, maybe queen a3 is not clear, but maybe rook c8 and then c3, and black should be better, because the king is very weak. And the pawn on d6 is also hanging, so... So here knight h2 is the only logical move. So here I thought for 15 or 20 minutes because I wanted to be sure. I played bishop h5, but okay, I have also this move. For example, it looks very interesting after take, 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 knight here, knight e3, and probably black is still better because, I mean, you have rook in two pieces, but the king is bad.
Yeah, the pieces aren't
developed. But the point is here I didn't like that he can take on c6 maybe. And this position was not so clear for me. For example,
b4?
Yeah, b4, knight d1.
Yes,
knight d1, queen e4, and some knight on e3. I was not sure which one, maybe this, maybe the other one. And okay, I have some initiative, maybe c3. But okay, I was not sure, so I just said that to myself, maybe bishop h5 is the best move. Because I wanted him to lose some tempos with g4 and then...
Because he can't really defend against the idea of losing the queen,
no,
so...
The whole point is here that maybe knight d5 was interesting because I don't have bishop e6, but now I have this very strong move.
I
attack on h2, and if you play bishop f4, I just take it, and maybe c3, but maybe also bishop b2. Should be enough for mate.
Yeah.
And then bishop c3.
It's coming. Yeah.
It should be good, yeah. Also, maybe c3 is also very impressive. So here, yeah, bishop, I think here is just lost probably for him. g4, or much worse, knight c6. And okay, he could still take here, but now it's different because the knight is very bad in h2, and I can play b4, I can take on d6, it's just different position. So he took here, king f8, now he played strange with bishop f4, but okay.
It's already gone wrong for white.
You can take, but I can even play here, and then queen d6, and the knight is hanging, and knight c2 is coming, and just...
He's got rook in two pieces for the queen, but the pieces are all very badly placed. So rook g4 seemed like a tempting move, but that was where it all went wrong for him.
Actually, he told me after the game that after bishop b6, he remembered something, but he, for some reason, bishop b6 was not his main move, and he was not sure, and okay, this kind of position can happen, you know.
And at what point did the power cut happen, and how was that fate?
Yeah, the power happened in after bishop f4.
We'll just go from here.
g5, bishop e3, so here it happened, after bishop e3. And I somehow didn't want to continue because I don't see good in when the shadows are on the board, I cannot see good. So I decided just to wait for the light and okay, maybe he was a bit angry, but I mean it's...
So you just let your clock, kept running?
Yeah, and they taught me that we can decide. If both players want to play, they can continue. If someone doesn't want, so... So I just needed a few minutes to calm myself, and I knew that the black is just completely winning here, so...
Well, it's a nice game to win with the black pieces in 23 moves against Daniel Yufa.
I was lucky in the opening, yeah, I was lucky. But still, I mean, I would be very bad if Rook G4 was winning, you know, because I would feel very bad, I mean.
But this is interesting, which I was making the point earlier, that when you know that the move is right with...
Yeah, but sometimes the point is that sometimes you... Because there's so many positions, and sometimes maybe you thought it's this position, but maybe it's different. So you just missed up the positions, and then you lose like...
In two moves, and you just blunder.
Oh, this happened to me before in rapid games. I mean, you just play some move, you thought this is a move, but then you lose in two moves, and then you go home.
Well, it's really good that you kept your nerves when this entire power cut situation was on, because it's obviously a difficult...
No, but for me it was easy, because I was winning. So
you were already winning. You played five moves right after.
Yeah,
and
I was... I needed a few minutes just to understand that I'm... Because I thought I'm much better, but then I understood that I'm just completely winning, so it's normal.
Well, always, in any case, always good to win a game with the black pieces. Otherwise, besides all the drama that happened today off board, happy with the way things are going?
Yeah, of course not for the moment. So far, so good for me, so...
We wish you all the best.
I hope I will come again here to comment some games, some Grunfeld maybe. So.
We look forward. Yeah. Grunfeld seems like your lucky line here right now.
Thanks.
Thank you, Ivan.
Thanks.